Hello students, welcome to Ahuja Classes Smartness in Education. In this lecture, we are going to solve some more numerical problems based upon the properties of the parallelogram which we have learned in the previous sessions. Let us see the first problem, which says that show that the bisectors of angles of a parallelogram form a rectangle. That means, suppose we have a parallelogram ABCD in which the bisectors of angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D have been drawn, which intersect each other at point P, Q, R and S respectively. So the quadrilateral formed by the bisectors of the angles of a parallelogram is a rectangle. That means we have to prove that PQRS is a rectangle. So to solve this, let P, Q, R and S be the points of intersection of angular bisectors of angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D respectively of a parallelogram ABCD. Now we have to prove that PQRS is a rectangle. PQRS is a rectangle. Now see carefully, since DS bisects angle D and AS bisects angle A, therefore the sum of the angle DAS, that means this angle, and ADS, that means this angle, is equal to half of the sum of the angle A and D respectively. To prove this, we will write angle DAS as half of angle A and angle ADS equals to half of angle D. So we get angle DAS plus angle ADS equals to half of angle A plus half of angle D. So we can also write half of angle A plus angle D. Now since ABCD is a parallelogram and AB is parallel to DC and AD is one of the transversal, then the sum of the interior angles on the same side of the transversal will be equal to 180 degrees. Now we will write angle DAS plus angle ADS equals to half of angle A plus angle D as equation number first. Now ABCD is a parallelogram and AB is parallel to DC. Write in this manner, in which AB is parallel to DC and AD is the transversal so that sum of interior angles on the same side of transversal is 180 degrees. That means we have angle A plus angle D equals to 180 degrees. Now from first we get angle DAS plus angle ADS equals to half of 180 degrees. This will be equal to 90. Angle DAS plus angle ADS equals to 90 degrees. This is equation number second. Now see the triangle ADS carefully. In triangle ADS, angle DAS plus angle ADS plus angle ASD equals to 180 degrees. By angle sum property, of a triangle. Here, the sum of DAS and ADS is 90 degrees plus angle ASD equals to 180 degrees. So we get angle ASD equals to 180 minus 90. That means we get angle ASD equals to 90 degrees. Since angle ASD and angle PSR are vertically opposite angles, so angle PSR will also be equal to 90 degrees. Since angle ASD equals to angle PSR by vertically opposite angles, therefore we can write angle PSR equals to 90 degrees. And similarly, we can find angle SRQ equals to angle RQ, P equals to angle SPQ equals to 90 degrees. Since in the collateral PQRS, all the angles are equal to 90 degrees, so PQRS is a rectangle. Since in quadrilateral PQRS, all the angles measure 90 degrees, so that PQRS is a rectangle. That's what we had to prove. So the angular bisectors of a parallelogram form a rectangle. Let us see the next problem, which says ABCD is a parallelogram in which P and Q are midpoints of opposite sides AB and CD as shown in figure. Here ABCD is a parallelogram in which P is the midpoint of side AB and Q is the midpoint of side CD, and if AQ intersects, here AQ is intersecting DP at point S and BQ intersects CP at point R, then we have to prove that APCQ, AP, CQ is a parallelogram. We will mark these different quadrilaterals by different colors. APCQ is a parallelogram. We have to also prove that DP, BQ, that means DP, BQ is a parallelogram, and PSQR is a parallelogram. That means this is the quadrilateral PSQR at the center. Now, to prove this, we will apply the properties of the parallelogram. Now, see the quadrilateral APCQ. In quadrilateral, for first part, APCQ, since AB is parallel to CD, so that AP will also be parallel to QC, and it is given that P and Q are the midpoints of sides AB and CD respectively. So AP, we also have AB, since ABCD is a parallelogram, since ABCD is a parallelogram, so opposite sides are equal and parallel. So AB is equal to CD, therefore half of AB will be equal to half of CD. Now AP is equal to half the length of the AB, and half the length of CD is equal to QC. So AP is equal to QC, since now we have from first and second that if a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel, then we can say that the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. And here from first and second, it is clear that the opposite sides AP and QC are equal and parallel, so that APCQ is a parallelogram. From first and second, it is clear that a pair of opposite sides, that means AP and QC, is equal and parallel, so that APCQ is a parallelogram. The first part has been proved. Similarly, we can also prove DP BQ is a parallelogram. So we will write here, similarly we can also prove DP BQ is a parallelogram. And now we have to prove PSQR is a parallelogram. To prove this, see carefully, since AP CQ is a parallelogram, since AP CQ is a parallelogram, so AP is equal to QC and AP is parallel to QC. Similarly, AQ is equals to PC and AQ is parallel to PC. Since AQ is parallel equal to PC and AQ is parallel to PC also, so we have QS will be parallel to RP, so that we can write QS is parallel to RP, and we also have DP BQ as a parallelogram. Let us mention that this is first. Now, since DP BQ is a parallelogram, therefore DQ is equals to PB and DQ is parallel to PB also, and DP is equals to QB and DP is also parallel to QB. So we can also write that this SP is parallel to QR, since it is a part of DP and QB. So from first and second, the opposite sides of a quadrilateral PQRS are parallel, so that PQRS is a parallelogram. Hence, proved. Now, in the next lecture, we will discuss about the midpoint theorem of the triangle, and then we will solve some numerical problems based on it. Thank you.